Maths is a wonderful subject if you completely get involved in it and enjoy it. Don't look at maths as a Jane ghost. Instead, let's have fun with its numbers. I'm Divya, your math facilitator. Let's play with numbers and get a step closer to maths. Firstly, before playing with numbers, let us play with chocolates. Here I am giving you 8 chocolates and you have to arrange these 8 chocolates in such a way that each row contains the same number of chocolates. Clear? So if you do so, these are the possible arrangements which you can do. So in the first arrangement, you can see that 8 chocolates are arranged in 8 rows. Okay, these are rows. Okay, and each row contains one single chocolate. Okay, so how did you arrange it? You arranged one chocolate in each row and in that way you have 8 rows. So can I write it in this way as 1 into 8? Yes. So this is nothing but we have arranged 8 chocolates. Now let us see the second arrangement. Now see, in the second arrangement, what have we done? We have arranged 2 chocolates each row. Yes. So we have taken 2 chocolates each rows, and how many rows can you find? So 1, 2, 3 and 4. So totally there are 4 rows. So 2 fours are 8. So you got the total 8 chocolates. Now let us see the third arrangement. Now in this arrangement, you can see that there are only 2 rows and 4 chocolates are arranged in each row. Okay. So number of chocolates are 4 arranged in each row and there are 2 rows. So totally 4 twos are 8. Now let us see the last type of arrangement where all the chocolates are arranged in one particular row. Okay. So that means 8 chocolates are arranged in one row. Yes. So can we write it in this way? So 8 ones are again total of 8 chocolates. Clear? So what have we done here? We have taken chocolates and we have arranged in rows such that each row contains the same number of chocolates. Other than these arrangements, can you tell me, are there any other arrangements possible? No. Right. So now let us come back here. Now we have written 1 into 8 is equal to 8. 2 into 4. 2 fours are 8. 4 twos are 8. And 8 ones are 8. This we got by arranging the chocolates in a particular pattern. Yes. Now if you closely observe, you can see that all these numbers here on the left hand side completely divides the number on the right hand side. Okay. Nothing but on the right hand side you have the number 8. Yes. So all these numbers on the left hand side are exact divisors of 8. Okay. I'm using the word exact divisors. Clear? So now for example, let us take a number 1. So I'm saying that these numbers are dividing 8 exactly. Okay. That means the remainder will be obviously 0. So 8 divided by 1. How do you do it? Okay, 1 8 is 8. Remainder is 0, which means 1 is dividing 8 exactly. Okay, let us take one more example. For example, 4. So 4 divided by 8. So 4 2s are 8. And the remainder is 0, which means again 4 is also dividing 8 exactly. So all these numbers are dividing 8 exactly. So these are called factors of 8. What are they called? They are called factors of 8. So nothing but the numbers which divide this particular number exactly are called factors. Okay. So the definition of factor is nothing but factor of a number divides a number exactly. Or you can also say that factor of a number is an exact divisor of that particular number. So now moving on to our next concept, multiples. Now let us understand multiples with an example. Okay, so I have taken marker cap to explain you this concept. Okay, so let me assume that the length of this marker cap is 3 centimeters. Okay, so nothing but suppose this is a marker cap and the length of it, this length, okay, it is 3 centimeters. Okay, now I am joining another marker cap of the same length to this marker cap. Okay, so now can you tell me what is the length of the complete marker? So this is one marker, this is the second marker cap. So this is 3 centimeters and this is also 3 centimeters. So the complete length is nothing but 6 centimeters here. Yes. So if you join another marker cap in the same way, so what happens now? So here you find one more marker cap which is of the same length, 3 centimeters. Okay, so the total length will be 9 centimeters. Yes, in this way, if I keep on increasing it, so the number is also increasing. Yes, so this particular number 3 I got by one marker cap. Yes, so can I write as 1 into 3? This 6 I got by 2 marker caps, so I'm writing it as 2 into 3, and we know that 2 threes are 6. And 9 you got by joining 3 marker caps of 3 centimeters each, so it is nothing but 3 into 3. Yes, now this 3, 6, 9 which you find here are called multiples, and here in this particular case 3, 6, 9 are nothing but the multiples of 3 because each division is of 3 centimeters. So in other ways speaking, so this is nothing but 1 into 3, 2 threes are, 3 threes are. So on your 3 table, your answers are nothing but multiples. So 1 into 3 is 3, 2 threes are 6, 3 threes are 9. So this 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 moving on are called multiples of 3. So now that we have learned factors and multiples, now if you closely observe these factors and multiples, there are few things which are common for all the numbers. So you may call it as properties of factors, okay? So which holds good for every number. Now for example, I have taken the previous case. So we have written the factors for 8, and we also said that factors are nothing but the exact divisors of that particular number. Now the first rule is that, or the first property is that, 1 is a factor of every number, and you can also see that 8 is a factor of itself. Yes, so we can say that every number is a factor of itself. Okay, so 1 is a factor of every number as well as that particular number. Here in this case it is 8, so every number is a factor of itself. Okay, now the third thing is that, nothing but our definition, we can say that factors divide that particular number exactly. Okay, nothing but factors are the exact divisors of that particular number. Yes, and now let us see the fourth property. And now you can see that factor of a number is always less than or equal to that particular number. Now here if I want to list out the factors, they are nothing but these left hand side are the factors. Yes, 1, 8, 4, 2 are the factors. Now again 2 is repeating, 4 is repeating, 8 is repeating, 1 is repeating, so I'm not writing. Okay, so 1, 8, 4, 2 are the factors of 8. Yes, here you can check that all the factors are either less than 8 or equal to 8. Here 8 is equal to 8, and all the other things 4 to 1 are less than 8. So factor of a number is always less than or equal to the given number. And the fifth point is that the factors are finite. Okay, that means there's a limit to the number of factors. In this case you can see that 1, 2, 3, 4 factors are there for 8. So you take any particular number, that factors are limited, that means you can count them. Clear? So these are the properties of factors. Now that we learned about factors, now let us see the general rules for multiples. Now we have seen the multiples of 3. Yes, so 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9. So 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18 and so on are nothing but multiples. Okay, this side, these are nothing but multiples. Yes, so now you can see that multiple of a number is always equal to or greater than the particular number. Okay, here we were writing the multiples of 3. Okay, in this case 3 is equal to 3, and in all other cases you can see that the multiple is greater than the number. Yes, so multiple is always greater than or equal to the particular number. Okay, and the second rule, general rule, is that the multiples are infinite. Okay, they are infinite. Why are we saying this? Now we have learned that numbers can be as large as possible. Yes, they are infinite numbers. So this 3 you can multiply with any number, however large it is. Okay, you are multiplying 3 with any large number, still you can get some answer. Yes, and this answer is nothing but multiple. So multiples are infinite. And the third general rule is that every number is a multiple of itself. So you can see 3 is a multiple of itself. Now let us talk about perfect number. Now what is a perfect number? A perfect number is nothing but a number in which the sum of the factors is equal to the twice of the number, then such a number is called perfect number. So for example, let us take number 6. Yes, now let us firstly write the factors of 6. It is nothing but 1 into 6, as we all know that 1 is a factor of every number. Yes, and then you can write 2 threes are 6. And then you can write 3 twos are 6. Yes, and then in 4 table you don't find 6, and in 5 table also it doesn't divide 6 exactly. And in 6 table you can write 6 ones are 6. And we have learned that factors are always less than or equal to the given number. So we don't have to check 7 because 7 is greater than 6. So we are not checking from 7, you will not check. Okay, so now see, now the factors of 6 are 1, 2, 3 and 6. Yes, again 1, 2, 3, 6 are repeating, so I am taking these 4. So these are nothing but factors of 6. Yes, now let us check for perfect number. Is 6 a perfect number or not? So how do you check it? I told you that the sum of factors should be twice the given number. So now these are the factors, let us add it. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6. 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 3, 6, and 6 plus 6 is 12. 12 is nothing but 2 into 6. Yes, that means the sum of the factors of 6 is nothing but twice the given number. So we can say that 6 is a perfect number. Moving on to our next concept, prime numbers. Now firstly, I have taken few numbers, okay, 1, 2, 3 and 4, and I wrote the factors of these particular numbers. Now you can see that 1 has only one factor, so 1 into 1, other than this there is no other possible factor for 1. Yes, now 2, you can write 2 as 1 into 2 or you can write 2 as 2 into 1. So the factors of 2 are 1 and 2. 3 also you can write 3 as 1 threes are or 3 ones are. So 1 and 3 are the factors of 3. Now coming to 4, 4 you can write as 1 into 4, 2 twos are 4 and 4 ones are 4. So the factors of 4 are 1, 2 and 4. Now if you observe here, excluding 1, now a number which has factors as 1 and itself, okay, 1 and the number itself are called prime numbers. Okay, here you can see that 2 has factors, 2 factors, okay, and out of which one factor is 1 and the other factor is the number itself. So 2 is a prime number. If you see 3, 3 also has only 2 factors, 1 and the number itself. So 2 and 3 are prime numbers. Now if you come to 4, 4 has 3 factors, okay. You find 1 is a factor of 4 and 4 is also a factor of 4, but there is one extra factor which is 2. Okay, so these numbers which have more than 2 factors are called composite numbers. Clear? So 2 is prime, 3 is prime and 4 is composite number. Now why did we leave 1? Now if you see, I told you that a number which has 1 and the number itself are prime numbers. Yes, and I also told you that the number which has more than 2 factors are composite numbers. But if you see 1, it is not matching with any of these definitions. Okay, so we say that 1 is neither prime. Let me write it in this way. 1 is neither prime nor or composite. So it is not satisfying either prime or composite. Now let us see what is C of Eratosthenes. Now we have learned what are prime numbers and how did I find prime numbers. Firstly, I wrote the factors of that particular number and checked if there are only 2 factors or not, nothing but if the factors are 1 and the number itself. If so, then I told you that that particular number is a prime number. So instead of writing the factors of each and every number, now there is an easier method. Okay, so using C of Eratosthenes, we can find the prime numbers from 1 to 100. So Eratosthenes is a Greek mathematician. He found this method of finding prime numbers in an easier way. Okay, so for this, we write the numbers from 1 to 100 as you can see on the screen. Okay, and firstly we cross out 1. So you are crossing out 1. Why? Because we learn that 1 is neither prime nor composite. And after 1, the next number you find is 2. So you encircle 2. Okay, the first step is you encircle 2 and then you cut all the multiples of 2. Nothing but you're crossing all the multiples of 2. Nothing but like 2, 4, 6, 8, you're crossing it. Okay, so doing so, you cross out all the multiples of 2 till 100. Okay, and now you can find that the next number is 3. So you encircle 3. And then you cross out all the multiples of 3 as we did for 2. Okay, and then you can see that the leftover number, the next number is 5. Similarly, you will encircle 5 and you will cross out all the multiples of 5. Okay, so 6 is already crossed out as a multiple of 2. Now the next remaining number is 7. So you encircle 7 and again you cross out all the multiples of 7. So in this way you can find the prime numbers. So you find that all the numbers which are encircling are prime numbers. Clear? So till 1 to 100, all the numbers which you have encircled are prime numbers. And all the numbers which you have crossed out other than 1 are composite numbers. So now let us talk about even and odd numbers. 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on are even numbers. Nothing but the multiples of 2 are even numbers. Okay, now the rest of the numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, the leftover numbers are odd numbers. Okay, so nothing but here the multiples of 2 are called even numbers. So now if I take a number, say for example 6, 4, 8, 9, 1, 2. Now I want to find it whether this is an even number or not. So how do I do it? If I start dividing it with 2 and then find, it is a little tedious process, yes? So instead we have an easier method. So you'll check for the ones place. In any number, you'll check for the ones place. If in ones place you find a number 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Okay, then that particular number is even. So here in ones place you find 2. Okay, so this particular number is even. Okay, suppose if there is a number 7, 8, 1, 3, 5, so now in this ones place you are finding 5, which is not 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, so this particular number is odd. So by just checking the ones place you can say a number is even or odd. Okay, and one more thing you can observe here is 2 is an even number, as well as we have learned that 2 is a prime number, yes? So 2 is the smallest even number. Yes, it is starting from 2. Even numbers are starting from 2. So it is the smallest even number as well as it is a prime number. Now, other than 2, all the other prime numbers are odd. Yes, 2, 3, 5, 7. So only 2 is even. 3, 5, 7 and so on, all the prime numbers are nothing but odd. So 2 is the only even prime number. Now, what are twin primes? Two prime numbers whose difference is 2 are called twin primes. Twin is nothing but 2. Yes, so two prime numbers whose difference should be 2. For example, 5 and 7 are prime numbers as we all know. Yes, so the difference 7 minus 5 is nothing but 2. So 5 and 7 are called twin primes. This brings us to the end of this video. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up, share it with your friends and don't forget to subscribe. You can also follow me on Facebook and Instagram. The links I have left in the description box below. You can also give me your valuable suggestions and comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.